Welcome to the Illinois School Virtual Teaching Program. My name is Brian Davis. I'm making an attempt to introduce government program. This is my first time teaching that. Now, my task here, first of all, is to introduce how government actually came into practice. Now, the story of government came into practice as a result of the evolution of man. Now, man is a social animal, and it evolved through various things. Now, if you can jog your memory back to the social story, you will notice that man evolved through various things. First of all, when man started the process of evolution, he was first of all a hunter, gatherer, moving around from place to place, and living in what is otherwise known as scattered communities. Now, as man evolved, he started living in what is otherwise known as a food. Well, then there came something. If you want to live in the food community, he gets to give what he felt like doing. Why? That simply means that there was no check to the activity of man. And so there was a need for an effective machinery to live. In place for an effective check on the machine of the activity of man. Now, this check to the activity of man was otherwise known as government. Now, first of all, I would just try to just give a brief preview, like a brief preview of the blackboard, on all what I've just said just right now. So, first of all, I would say, okay, man, social, right? And he evolved. Now, if you are very conversant with social studies lesson, you will know the various stages that man evolved from. And the evolution of man was a gradual process. And man, when he evolved, he was first of all to lead to so man. Now, when man lived in what is otherwise known, he was a hunter and a gatherer. Now, that means man knew about what he in order to be the means of survival. So when man lives in this category, he allows one to live in order to be the means of Now, as the evolution of man gradually progressed, we saw man settling down and living in settled community. So, as man evolved, Fine. So as man evolved, we saw man living in the truth. Now, when man evolved and started living in the truth, it just ended. Man had to compete for failures. Now, what is this? These are the various means that ensure the survival of man. Man has to compete for various successes. Yes, John, can you give me the various means that man has to compete? What? Yes, man has to compete with other human beings for love, yes, water, mineral, and most importantly, food. I repeat, John, man has to compete for survival for land, water, minerals like gold, diamond, etc. And most important, food. Now, when man finally settled down and started competing for various tests, the idea sprung up among themselves for the need for the establishment of a form of institution that could serve as a check on the activity of man. So after man settled down and lived in the community, there was the idea for man to sort of bring about a form of institution that would serve as a check on the activity of humans. Now the institution that would serve as a check on the activity of all human beings. In government. So let's go. And evolve someone evolving and living in a certain community. So after man evolved and lived in a certain community, what happened? Man had a monkey. Other humans or babies what's that? Man, water, mineral, settled down and leave the certain community. And other communities for this very office. The idea of the need for government is coming. Now, can someone tell me why was it necessary for there to be a need to form a government? Yes. My head. Now it was necessary to form a government to serve as a check on the activities of human beings. So I will get down that. Now, if necessary to form a government, Not to do that. Now, our goal is for you to jot down this blackboard, after which I will move government forward. To define goal. Mind you, I will give you this definition of government, after which I will explain to you what government is all about. What the definition of government is that government is that political, political, or civil authority that is constitutionally responsible, accountable to the local community, power and mandate to make laws for the good order and administration according to the principles of universal adult suffrage, human rights, and the rule of law. Now, I will now proceed to jot down the definition of government and make an attempt to explain what I mean by the definition. And now you see. Now, looking at the definition of just a poet, government in fact constitutionally elected by the people. Now, the people are there, you understand? And the government stands as a representative of the people. are the people. The government is responsible to account for whatever action that it takes. Because the people who in fact gave them the power and mandate to go through the ballot box and only go through. And it is also the people who gave them the power and mandate to make laws for the good order, which is happening for the whole understand? Now, according to the principles of the universal principle, what does the universal principle mean? That means that all qualified adults who have reached the universal age are entitled to follow the rule of law. Like it says here, it's basically saying that all individuals are equal before the law, regardless of the status. Understand? So this is the fourth definition of government. I will now be going to give you the second definition of now, the second definition I will give you to government is that government is a body of citizens in which laws are made, interpreted, and enforced in the state. So, definition two, government is a body of citizens in which law that is where I am in a state. Definition B that I'm about to give you was given by the famous American president, the name of Abraham Lincoln. Using the Lincoln definition of government, he defined government as government, the people, for the people, and by the people. Lincoln defined government of the people, for the people, and by the people. Now, a government is expected to be elected of the people. Understand? And it is expected to be representative for the people. Understand? And it is expected to make laws with the approval by the people living in a state. Understand? Now your brain can be further expanded into three new areas. That is the meaning of those. Can you further explain using new areas? First one is dolphin as an institutional state. Two, the process of the art of dolphin. And three, dolphin as an academic field. So, I'll just move on and give you in which dolphin can be further extinct, and the fish of dolphin can be further extinct. Alright, so I want to explain that government can be further explained using three main areas. Government has a process, the academic institution of the state, government has a process, art of government, and government has an academic field of the modern. I now proceed to explain the first heading, which is government as an institution. Now let me see how it works. And this state has an institution. Understand? What is an institution? Understand? An institution is an organization that is set up to carry out specific and duty. Now the organization that is charged to carry out the specific task and duty is known as the government. Now the story of government as an institution is very important because it makes us to know the political structures of government in various countries, like the USA, Great Britain, Nigeria, etc. But then, in order for a government to function effectively, it must be from a government political structure known as the organ of government. Yes, class. Can you name the organs of government in which government can be supported into? Yes. And who? Legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. Yes, class. Can you give me the functions of these three organs you just mentioned? Okay. Legislature, responsible for lawmaking, executive implementation and enforcement of policies of the government, and the judiciary, interpreting laws and the punishing of lawbreaker. Now let's go see whether I got the right question. Now, for the next lesson, the assignment I want to give you is to expand on the video heading I am just giving you. Remember, I am just explaining on government as an institution. Now, the assignment I'm giving you. For you to research on government as important for us, for government and academic. I will now end this lesson and hope you do this assignment properly.